Who brought the sauce?
I brought the sauce.
Who made the sauce?
I made the sauce.
What's in the sauce?
I am the sauce.
Who brought the sauce? Okay.
With a bit more thought, we can all do our part to keep plastic out of the ocean.
Hi, we're just here to order the Whopper.
This is McDonald's.
Yeah. And we don't have
Wait, you don't have the Burger King Whopper here?
No. We don't have Whoppers here. This isn't Burger King.
No. The app for Burger King? You see it?
I believe you. I see it, but we don't have that.
So we can come to McDonald's and get a Whopper, yeah?
Maybe in another state.
We don't sell Whoppers. It's only Big Macs.
It says buy a 1 cent Whopper at McDonald's.
That's crazy.
Sorry, I'm just trying to get my Whopper.
Have you heard about the crazy Whopper deal?
Yeah, everybody's been asking, but like, we never heard of it, ever.
Can you do a Whopper Jr.?
They probably can make that. It wouldn't be as good as Burger King would, to be honest with you.
Oh, that's Burger King. This is McDonald's, sweetie.
Well, I pushed on here, and it said order a Whopper for a penny at McDonald's.
That's a lie. That's a fake thing.
Okay, where's the Burger King?
Right, 4 blocks to your left.
Burger King wants you to come here. Yes to McDonald's.
Burger King is trolling its fast food rival
with a promotion available through the Burger King mobile app.
Yeah, but there is a small catch.
So I saw this Burger King commercial where you could
get a Whopper for a penny.
Only if you open the app while you're at McDonald's.
That doesn't even make sense. You have to go to McDonald's for a Whopper?
Whopper?
Use Burger King's BK app,
then be within 600 feet of a McDonald's restaurant.
Burger King geofenced over 14,000.
14,000 McDonald's restaurants in the U.S.
Unbelievable.
So I've parked my news car about 100 feet from a McDonald's.
I feel weird. I'm at McDonald's getting a coupon for Burger King. I almost feel like I'm stealing.
Let's go for the unlock.
Yes!
Ah! You unlocked the Whopper detour.
This is a really cool promo, guys. How fun is this?
Woo!
brilliant promotion. It's awesome. Like having a little fun.
Can you do a Whopper Jr.?
They probably could make that. It wouldn't be as good as Burger King would, to be honest with you.
Okay, where's the Burger King?
Like 4 blocks to your left.
Gemma?
Gemma? How you doing?
And what's your name?
It's James.
James?
Thank you. Mrs. Long?
Yes?
We've found a baby girl for your adoption, but there are some things you need to know. She's in Siberia, and she was born with a rare condition. Her legs will need to be amputated. I know this is difficult to hear. Her life, it won't be easy. Mrs. Long?
It might not be easy, but it'll be amazing. I can't wait to meet her.
We believe there is hope and strength in all of us. Toyota, proud partner of Team USA.
Instagram made body image issues worse for 1 in 3 teen girls.
You can make your nose smaller, your hips bigger, your waist skinnier.
Young patients wanting surgery so they can look more like they do in filtered selfies.
What's often called Snapchat dysmorphia.
I have no doubt that Instagram helped kill my daughter.
Have you seen the new Dove ad that's getting a lot of attention? It's called Reverse Selfie. It shows a young girl undoing the dramatic changes she made to a photo that's been posted to social media.
I think stuff on like social media is toxic and it just makes you have like a bad mindset.
I think that's how society has pictured women.
When I saw myself in the Dove campaign for the first time, I felt like I could finally accept myself for who I am.
It tells girls they should be confident with their natural self.
Lizzo is getting real about body image. The singer recently posted this unedited photo of herself.
I have nothing to hide. You know, there's no shame anymore.
The photo is part of Lizzo's partnership with Dove for their self-esteem project.
And I think when they undid the changes, she was more beautiful than even what she was striving to be.
Finally, our youth can say, wow, okay, I look like that. Like me. Yeah. Yeah.
Hi, and welcome to this very natural setting. Today, I want to talk about a revolutionary approach on how to connect our world without being super weird. Some said it's not possible. Some said it's out of reach. To them, we say, it's already here. Seriously, look, it's right here. And what do we call this not so new chapter in human connectivity? The Iceland worse. Enhanced, actual reality without silly looking headsets. In our open world experience, everything is real. And has been for millions of years. it's completely immersive. With water that's wet. With humans to connect with. You're human, right? Isn't she funny? In the Iceland Wars, there's real moss you can look at, but please don't touch, it's very delicate. Skies you can see with your eyeballs. Volcanic rocks you can caress. Really big geysers you can observe from a safe distance. Birds you can watch. They're really cute, but a bit stupid. Waterfalls you can stand near, like this one, that one, this one, that one, and even this one. Horses you can ride, with hair you can touch. The Iceland Wars is a world with possibilities so endless, they'll be here forever. So join us today, or tomorrow, or whenever. We are really easygoing. Now, please enjoy our logo.
Hello, this is Osman Mack from the New York Times. We didn't know what kinds of people we were upsetting. Like, something's fucked up in this thing. I don't know what it is. Something's wrong. But I swear, after my medical New York Times.
I am really worried. We need to leave the country. Somebody had gone through all of my stuff. They are coming after me. Like, I think we're all being hacked.
My fear is that they show the willingness to kill.
Check it out. That's the direction of government. If they want to touch you, they will.
Start somewhere.
I'm a reporter from the New York Times.
I'm aware of bank statements, tax returns, thousands of property records, deeds, and mortgages.
1995 showed that he was bleeding money.
Go through it all, understand it all.
Holy.
Number by number, brick by brick.
That's when we realized
that's fraud.
I built this empire. I did it by myself.
The government wanted to present its narrative.
The military is everywhere.
The government is seeing the Rohingya burn down their own houses. They had started to believe it.
This is the repatriation center.
But he's scared.
Here from the New York Times.
Yeah.
I'm trying to understand the ideology of ISIS.
How does ISIS prepare you to kill people?
You had to know how to slice the head off. The blood was just everywhere.
You didn't question that?
I didn't know. But what the hell did I just do?
It's voicemail.
See this?
Holy shit.
Been reports that you are considering separating children from their mothers at the border?
Only if the situation requires it.
So if you thought the child was endangered,
sure.
That's the only circumstance to which you would separate?
Can't imagine doing it otherwise.
It's Caitlin Dickerson from the New York Times calling you back.
You give your first and last name?
Caitlin Dickerson, see?
I have to call one woman to ask her about specific children.
I'm an immigration reporter here at the Times.
This isn't the only case.
Please be in touch as soon as possible.
But I know that's not true.
Miss Caitlin Dickerson, you're at the Times.
We can talk by landline phone. I can meet you at your house. And the shelters really don't know what to do with them. Very little documentation. But I know that's not true.
I'm an immigration reporter here at the Times. Deadline is noon tomorrow.
But I have this number. I need you to tell me if you've seen this number. I just confirmed this. I just got another person at DHS to confirm this.